Cheers.
So picture this. You're out with friends, sipping on a glass of red wine, when suddenly a bad headache strikes. But why? You only had one glass of wine.
I'm getting notes of dried robin's blood.
Well, studies show that red wine is the main culprit for these sudden alcohol headaches. And new research out of UC Davis explains what exactly is behind this phenomenon. This type of sudden headache differs from the typical hangover headache that appears after a night of heavy drinking. Red wine headaches occur much sooner, sometimes even before you finish the first glass. And it turns out, the culprit is a big part of what gives red wine its signature color, grape skins. This part of the grape contains a compound called quercetin, and this compound is fairly common. In addition to grapes, quercetin is also found in cherries and citrus fruit. But eating a handful of cherries doesn't normally cause a sudden headache. So, what's different when it comes to red wine? Researchers believe it's the combination with alcohol that's key. Typically, your body breaks down the alcohol you drink in two stages. First, from alcohol into acetaldehyde, which is toxic, and next, into acetate, which is pretty harmless. Researchers found that quercetin blocks the enzyme that's responsible for the second step. This causes the toxic acetaldehyde to build up in your bloodstream. That can cause headaches and nausea within minutes of your first sip. Acetaldehyde is also known for causing the type of infamous flush that some people get when drinking, where their face turns warm and pink. It could also play a big role in those hangovers you get the next day, but more research needs to be done.
Oh my god, I'm so hungover. I've never been this hungover.
So why is it that only some people experience these headaches from red wine? Well, scientists still aren't sure, and the UC Davis researchers want to uncover the reasons why. This work could also help winemakers cultivate grapes with lower levels of quercetin. So when you're picking out wine for dinner, and don't want to risk a headache, you might want to switch to white wine. And no, this isn't advice from the Chardonnay lobby. These wines typically have a lot less quercetin in them. So what do you think? Do you get red wine headaches? Let us know in the comments below. And check out our other episode on what sugar actually does to your body.